welcome to this special edition of The Today Show. It's 1964. Nice to see you, Lisa.
Nice to see you too, Carlos.
Well, you look tip-top today.
Why, thank you.
Pump it up, Lisa.
So many nights.
I don't want to talk over the great Doc Neeson.
There's only one line in this that you need to know.
Well, just under your breath, everyone.
Should we go again?
You all did it.
All right.
That's fun.
Yeah, it is fun. We should beep it later.
Can't be accused of anything.
You can do whatever you want.
Two days to go. That's true.
Actually, we could say that to her.
Yeah, exactly.
Ever gonna see your face again?
No.
Oh, they love each other.
Not
really,
Georgie.
They do. And good morning to you, Georgie. What
morning,
morning. Did you have a lovely Mother's Day?
I did. Thank you very much.
Did you get on it?
What does that mean?
Have a few champagnes?
No, I didn't actually. Oh. No. I was out for dumplings, yum cha.
Oh, beautiful.
Lunch.
Life gets boring as you get older, doesn't it?
Do you reckon?
Yum cha's exciting.
Yum cha is never boring.
It's exciting.
Never,
did
ever
you have
boring.
The rooster feet?
No, I saved those for you.
He's trying to live your life vicariously, Georgie. Give him some joy.
Keep your rooster feet to yourself.
Now, I've already done a little scout of the market, and I found you all a gift, and I know you're going to love it. So, for the boys, Fordo and Carl, I just got you this, which I think would be wonderful for your Friday nights. It's just a little kangaroo G-string.
It's an eye patch.
A little kangaroo G-string. So, that's by Pauline and Mike here at the kangaroo shop.
It's itchy.
And for the girls, don't worry, I didn't forget you, Georgie and Lisa.
I just got you some G-string.
No, you got kangaroo fur nipple covers.
Oh, perfect.
Oh, no.
Perfect.
When are we meant to get those out, Emma?
Friday night. Georgie's farewell.
Just a Friday night, Lisa. Just a Friday night. Exactly right.
Georgie's
farewell.
Get your kangaroo on.
That's enough, Skip.
What's that, Georgie? Get me another tequila.
Oh, she's thoughtful, that Emma Friedman, isn't she?
Make sure you bring those back, Nems. That's going to be fun.
All right, now, we all know celebrities receive lots of love from fans, but they also get a lot of hate.
That's true.
Here they go, reading out a few of the nasty tweets.
Emma Stone looks like she smells like cat. Okay.
All right, so if you want to say something about us that's nasty, go right ahead now.
Oh, stop it. Please don't encourage
No, I'll read them out. I don't mind.
Direct them his way.
Just send them to me and I'll read them out a little bit later in the program.
Just lastly, in the buzz, I told everyone I was going to read out some mean tweets.
Yes, what are they saying about you?
Okay, so Courtney hits things off with, Carl giggles like a girl. Kerry says, Carl, I'm tired of your continual attention seeking. I love it when you are on leave. When is your next holiday? Woo! Amanda says, if Carl smiled any harder, he would crack my screen. Ooh. Ooh. And Joan says, Carl, I like you better when you're drunk. But don't worry, I like me better when I'm drunk too.
Cookie, I wonder if you would be able to be so kind as to do the weather for us.
Oh, me not sure me qualified, but me give it a shot.
You don't need to be qualified to be a weather person.
You don't need like a degree from college or anything. You can just do it.
No, you can just do it. I think.
Me gonna give it a shot.
Okay.
We'll see what happens.
Okay, well, should we start with Brisbane? What is the weather going to be?
Whoa! That me kind of weather.
Me too.
Oh, boy, Brisbane. Well, looks like possible shower with a little bit of cookie. in the weather.
What about further south in Sydney?
Oh, Sydney.
How old is Sydney?
Okay, look like we got the shower or two developing and the cookie. And the cookie there, too.
And what about Melbourne?
Melbourne, mostly sunny with chance of cookie. So we're not going to go there.
Poor Melbourne.
A chance of cookie.
Good.
Dickie, that was the saddest movie you've ever seen.
I think so, yeah.
The Tom Cruise one.
No, not the Tom Cruise. No, it was the Fault in Our Stars. Oh.
Better than Terms of Endearment?
Sadder than Terms of... Yeah, I think so. That was sad, too.
Sadder than Terminator 4 when Arnie got lowered into the pit?
That was a touching moment. But, yeah, sadder than that, Carl.
Sadder
than Happy Feet 2?
Sadder than Happy Feet 2.
Kramer versus Kramer.
Who
Will
Love
My Children?
Who Will Love...
What about Flintstones, the movie?
Flintstones
was sad.
What about Porky's 4?
Don't you? Don't buy into it, Lisa.
What about Police Academy 8?
It's a sad film, all right?
All right.
Fault in Our Stars. Take your Kleenex with you.
Police Academy 8 where the guy did the thing in the pool. That was sad.
Yeah, that's probably...
It was sad for the pool cleaner, that's for sure.
Chiquito, I think they called it.
Carl, you are an idiot.
Chiquito.
But I love you.
We shouldn't encourage him, should we?
We all have different levels of sad, don't we?
Because you're a sneaky devil. You're doing American Idol at the moment. Mm. You do that on a Wednesday and a Thursday.
Wednesday and Thursday.
And then so you sneak in and out of Australia between.
Yeah, times. I'll actually fly in there Wednesday morning, you know, and shoot the show that night, shoot the show Thursday night, get on a plane and come straight back down again.
That's very cool.
So thank you, Qantas. I sent the props.
Very good. Do you get your jammies?
I've got a big... you must have a collection now, too.
Not as big as yours, my friend.
Are we talking about jammies?
Yeah, we are. We are talking about... But bigger than Bob Carr's collection of
jammies. I was on the plane one time with Robbie Williams, I kid you not, and this is a few years back.
Think before you speak.
I'm just saying, it's a few years back, and I think Robbie was so taken with the jammies, he just got off in them. Got off the plane.
Got off the plane.
Yes. Yeah. Well, he probably did both.
Well, good morning again. I'm not quite sure how to top that. We have an awesome band to introduce you today in Fresh Act Friday. But first... You're early.
And imagine, if you will, a year in the wild with absolutely no modern comforts. We speak to the woman who went back to nature.
Good on her. Is that her?
I think that's Tom
Hanks. She's got a lovely beard, hasn't she?
Yeah, she took
Looks
no
like your Auntie Ethel.
She took no modern comforts, but she took Tom Hanks, and I think that probably means she was probably
It's your Auntie Ethel, though.
She did have an impressive beard.
Didn't she?
Good music. You know what day it is today, folks?
Friday.
It's Superhero Day, Fordo.
Oh.
And this is what I do on the weekends. Get ready.
Oh.
Oh, you do.
So get
That's
ready, folks.
Impressive.
Get dressed up and fight crime in whatever way you can.
Is that what you look like underneath your clothes, Carlos?
I don't know who that is, Lisa.
Well, it looks like you and Ava.
It's not me. It's Mr. Invisible.
But I love the barbecue backdrop.
Yeah.
Fantastic.
Invincible. And I think that's Hit Girl. Right. Do not trifle with the rifle.
Wow. Oh, gee. Wow.
So anyway, if you've got photos of superheroes or you dressed up as a superhero, please send them in. Facebook, Twitter or email. Wow.
Good stuff. What were you off to do there?
Look how fight expensive crime. His barbecue is.
He was going out to buy sausages.
To fight crime. No need for sausages.
Take the sausages.
No need for them.
Jeez. Oh, dear.
Nice. Ah!
Whoops.
His head's come off.
Before we go too much further, I know you get very distracted in cooking segments.
Yes.
So, mate, bacon and egg roll with barbecue sauce. There you go. Keep you busy.
Keep it quiet.
Keep it out of our hair.
Keep it quiet while I'm busy.
Plan ahead.
All right. So, Scott, get chopping.
Now, Carl, there was a reason that Luke gave you that bacon and egg roll this morning.
No.
Not only to keep you quiet, but he's also got a bit of a man crush.
Does he?
Yeah.
A man crush.
Well, I'm a bit excited to be cooking for you this morning.
Sure.
It'd be fair to cook you.
It's the closest thing to brekkie in bed for us.
Well, I tell you what.
Should I leave you boys alone?
I think so.
No, I'm with you,
Lisa. We'll just exchange numbers.
I think we'll come on. Yeah. We'll
so should we
alone.
Finish this segment off?
I tell you what, give an inch and they take a mile. Right? What points something out in that photo, though? Just that, and I'm being serious here.
Mm-mm.
Just the fruit looks really healthy there in New York, doesn't it?
Stop it!
Am I the only one that...
The melons in the background you're talking about.
Oh, I didn't say that. Just into... I've been in New York millions of times, so I've never seen fruit like that.
Is there a risk they've photoshopped those melons?
I reckon they might.
Oh, stop it. Hats off to her. I think she was thinking
Hats
of this.
Hats off. Shirts off.
Tops off.
Comfy.
This is an Australian first.
And there's probably a reason for that.
Up next, who knows what we're going to do next? Just let the good times flow.